Hello developers, last week I launched a mobile app on both Google Play Store and Apple App Store within 6 days. And in this video, I will share the exact same steps so that you can follow the same process and launch your own mobile apps on both Google Play Store and Apple App Store within weeks, not in months. I will share the exact tool that I used, exact process that I followed. So watch video till end, it's going to be interesting. So let's start from the beginning. So if you are watching this video, I assume you know at least basics of building mobile apps. You know Flutter or you know React Native or any other tool for building mobile apps. But since we are talking about launching on both Google Play Store and Apple App Store, I believe you must be thinking about going cross-platform, because if you will not go with cross-platform, then you have to write separate code for Android and iOS. That will take longer time. So here you have to follow the cross-platform route. Now comes the second step, the idea, what you want to build. So I had this idea of building this AI body scan application where you can just simply take a picture of your full body. It will analyze your full body and based on that, it will give your fitness score. It will give your all the detail of your fitness, like what are muscle tones, what is your posture, what are the things that you can improve, and what are the good and bad things about your body. So this was a simple and straightforward idea. I thought it will be helpful for fitness freaks to measure their fitness over time, like how progress they are making. So second step, you have to think about idea. It can be a simple idea or it can be a very complex idea. So just think about what you are gonna build. Next, once we decide the idea, like yes, I want to build AI body scanner application, then the third step is to think how to build. So in the third step, we are using Cursor or Copilot or any other AI assistant tool that you prefer. I prefer Copilot. So I used Copilot to code this application. So how you have to start? Just go on ChatGPT, write your idea, what you want to build, and then write generate a prompt to build this application using these things. So let's say I decided I will be using OpenAI Vision API. So I just given that context. So I given this context of like I will be using the OpenAI as a backend. And then I given the context like it will be just a simple take a picture from the camera or upload a picture from the gallery. So be specific about your context. Be clear what you want to build. I also given the context like I will be using DAIO for networking in Flutter. So all the context that you have, just provide it. Once you will give all the context, all the detail what you want to build, just ask ChatGPT to give you prompt to build that. Don't ask ChatGPT to build it, because we are using Cursor or Copilot, not the ChatGPT. So just ask a good prompt from ChatGPT by giving all these context. So now you got your prompt from ChatGPT, copy that prompt, refine it. If you see some points are invalid or some unnecessary points are added, just refine it, because the first prompt that we are going to give is going to be very important. So just copy that prompt, come in your Cursor or Copilot and use the agent mode. So in Copilot, just select agent mode, copy your long prompt and let Cursor or Copilot generate your complete project. So initial first prompt will be very important. So once I gave this prompt for building this application, Copilot took some time and then my application was running. There were no error in the code, but you might encounter some errors. So again, just if you see some errors come, just open Copilot or Cursor and ask to fix those errors. It will fix immediately. So this was the building step. Till here, you might not get the expected result or expected UI in your application. So what next you have to do? The fourth step is refining step. In refining step, just see the UI, see the implementation. If you feel like on UI, there should be this kind of layout, not the current one. So just ask Copilot or Cursor to implement. But yes, don't get stuck in just implementing, changing feature, tweaking the UI. No, just you have to launch fast. Our target is launching fast. So just see if it is looking good. Just go ahead with that. So that's what process I followed. Just after giving the first long prompt, I got almost good UI, but something was missing, like the theming was not what I wanted. So I just asked to revamp the complete theme of the application, and then it was perfect. So just see and refine in the fourth step. In this step, we will prepare our application for production release. So after this step, our development related task will be done. So what are some essential things that you should have in your application before publishing on App Store or Google Play Store? So one thing is paywall, definitely. If you want to publish some app, if you want to make money, then definitely you want to implement paywall. For paywall in Flutter, I use revenue cut paywall, and even I have created my own custom package to simplify this process even further. I will put those documentation link to integrate paywall in the description as well. You can check. After paywall, another important thing to integrate is the analytics, so that you know what users are doing in your application, which features they are liking, what is the time span that they are spending in your application. And for that, I use Mixpanel. It is simple to use, straightforward, and you get first 1 million events free each month. So I think that is enough if you are just starting. Next thing that we need before building our application for production is the feedback or support, so that user can send their feedback, support. And for that, you don't need any complex feature. Just give your number, your email somewhere, so that if user are really interested and they want to send feedback, they can use that feedback. You can use that number or email to give you feedback. These were the necessary feature before releasing our app to production. Now just few more things are left. Update app icon. And for app icon, I use ChatGPT. I have a custom prompt for that, so that you can get a beautiful, perfect app icon for your application. I have prepared it. It's a long prompt. I will give it in the description. You can update the keywords according to your own app, but for layout, for looking it like the app icon, you can use the exact same prompt. So once we have app icon ready, just update your app icon. And there are some other steps that we need to follow, like for Android, we have to sign in our application, and for iOS, I think we have to update some details, some info.plist. We need to add some manifest file in Android. So all those processes you will get in that documentation. So it will take your couple of hours. You can go through that and you can prepare your application for production build. So after following these five steps, our application is ready to be published on Google Play Store and Apple App Store both. Now comes the sixth step, where we will publish our app on Play Store. To create an account on Google Play Console, you have to go on the Play Console website. If you are a new developer, you don't have an account, just sign up there. Initially, it requires one-time payment of $35 or $50. I don't exactly remember, but it is just a few dollars, no subscription. And once you will have the account, you can publish your apps there. Next is the seventh step, where we will publish our app on App Store. And for that, you need to have $100 yearly subscription on Apple developer account, and it is compulsory. There is no other option to publish apps if you don't have Apple developer account subscription, because you cannot even build for production if you don't have Apple developer account subscription, because you have to register your bundle ID. All those processes you have to follow. I have created a custom Figma design for this, so that every time I do follow the process of releasing my app on App Store, I follow these processes. I will give the link. I will make this design public and give the link of this design in the description, so that you can follow all the steps, like starting from registering your bundle ID to updating your store listing details on App Store. Your app now will be ready to publish on App Store. Now comes the eighth step where we will update our listing details. So here we will do same on both Play Store and App Store. So here our title can be same on App Store and Play Store, or you can do some research and based on the searching or demand you can update your title on both the stores. And then description also, for the long description we can utilize the ChatGPT. Just give the detail about your app and say to generate a long description for your application, and it will generate a comprehensive description. Just be mindful to remove emojis or any keywords that might not qualify for the policy. So just watch once and you can go ahead. So title, description, all those things you can do research with ChatGPT and then update it. And next, you need to update your skin shots on both Play Store and App Store. And for that, I personally use Canva. So Canva is very easy and straightforward. There are amazing mockups available. So just go on Canva, upload your screenshot, use some mockups, design your listing. So that is the process that takes usually, for me it takes around 1 to 2 hours. It will depend on like how well you know that website and the process. So till here, till this step, our Play Store listing is ready with icon, listing details, screenshots, our App Store description and listing icons, all those things are ready. There are some additional things that you need to follow on Play Store and Google App Store before publishing your application. So I will give the link for those videos as well, so you can watch those simple steps and complete the remaining processes. Now we will submit the application on both Google Play and Apple App Store. Once submitted, it will take 1 or 2 days. It depends, sometimes it will even take longer. So once submitted, within 1 to 2 days you will get to know if your application is rejected or accepted. In my case, it was accepted in first time on App Store, and on Play Store it was rejected one first time because in description there were some keywords like free or something like that that I had used. Because of that it got rejected, so I updated the description, and then in second attempt it got accepted. So these were the steps and tools that I used in each steps. You can follow the same process, same tool, same step to launch your own app on both Play Store and App Store. Initially, if you are going through these steps for the first time, it might take you longer, but yes, once you will go through these steps first, second, third time, it will be very simple. You can launch your app literally in days, not even in weeks. So that was all about this video. If you found this helpful, give a thumbs up